obviously the show will be different. We are not anticipating 110,000 people, maybe more like 30,000. We have still plenty of big brand names. I'm sitting in Orange's booth right now. We have Telefonica, we have Huawei, we have ZTE, and a whole bunch of other really, really interesting brands. We are focusing quite a lot on 4 years from now, so much more of an innovative approach this year.
Mats, I can see it looks very similar based on that exhibition behind you. Can I ask you about this big report you've got coming out today? You've picked up on a number of trends, and I think we all realise the power of connectivity, how important it has been during this COVID crisis to stay connected. But we've got this major transition in the backdrop from 4G to 5G, and clearly there's been a huge acceleration in those digital trends. Has that made a difference to what operators are able to do in terms of bringing forward 5G?
I think so. I mean, if you remember when you interviewed me last in February of 2019, there was actually only three live 5G networks at that time. And now, 2.5 years later, we have 160 live networks in 65 countries. In fact, we're forecasting that 5G will have a 40% quicker uptake than 4G after 3 years of service. So the momentum of 5G has picked up tremendously. And I would argue that the need for connectivity during a pandemic is quite evident, and 5G gives us that connectivity and unmatched both speeds and lower latency.
You say that, Matt, but I'm pretty happy. I was going to go on to a different question, but I'm pretty happy on 4G at the moment. My home network, I've got phenomenal speeds despite living in the middle of nowhere. My 4G seems great as well. And was it you or perhaps it was Borja Ekholm, who was talking about actually it's not going to be the great leap forward that many people thought it was going to be. So, you know, it's going to be more incremental as well. So are we really going to get the big leap? Am I really going to notice the difference when I finally upgrade to 5G?
I think you will. I think we need to be somewhat patient. I've had this question many times. So what's the need for 4G when we have fantastic speeds on 3G? But then you have all these new cool applications coming on 5G that we don't really know today. And I mean, the mobile operator community is experts in investing and innovating into the unknown and imagining just a pretty cool future. And that's exactly what's happening here. But to some extent, I must agree with Börje from Ericsson that 5G will possibly be a bigger difference for enterprise than 4G ever was. We see the opportunity to do network slicing, to have a quality of services that we can actually predict, almost like a fiber in the air, if you would like, and not just the best effort. So you will see more of an enterprise influence over 5G. Massive amount of IoT connections are doable with 5G, much more so than in a 4G environment.